NYSORA YouTube channel team chooses the topics for the videos according to the relevance to the field and the request by our viewers. But if you have a suggestion for a topic or for an article review, simply send your idea to the info@nysora.com and we will consider it, definitely. And if you find our videos useful, do subscribe to NYSORA's YouTube channel so that you're notified when the next videos become available. Based on viewers' requests, we're going to feature a series of videos on Exparel, or Liposomal Bupivacaine. In the series, we will cover some truly fascinating developments with this formulation of Bupivacaine. We will dissect the literature and share clinical experiences, and I will also stick my neck out to state that we are shooting ourselves in the foot by failing to conduct very needed clinical studies that inform the practice of regional anesthesia of the best modes of application of this formulation of bupivacaine that can extend the clinical value of the interventional regional anesthesia techniques that we use. If you've ever opened a regional anesthesia journal, you would see that much of the literature in regional anesthesia focuses on the nuances of techniques and anatomy, needle here versus needle there. And at this time, I think it's fair to say that we know as much about anatomy and spread of the local anesthetics as we need to successfully practice. But with our focus on techniques, we have become so technical and complicated that many clinicians are completely confused by the minuscule differences among literally hundreds of new ultrasound-guided injection techniques. We have neglected the most significant development in local anesthetics in 20 years, the liposomal bupivacaine. But without exploring the utility of the new pharmacology for the well-established neuroblocks, regional anesthesia may not have a very promising future. This is because the benefits of the neuroblocks and all of these new injection techniques are limited to a few hours because of the short duration of the existing local anesthetics. Unfortunately, as the liposomal bupivacaine or Exparel became approved, we continued dissecting cadavers and creating new techniques instead of embracing the new formulation of bupivacaine and figuring out how to use this slow-release formulation of the local anesthetic to extend the benefits of regional anesthesia. Being a suspension rather than a solution, Exparel definitely needs to be applied differently, and these are the studies that we need to do so we can figure out what's the best way to use it. Is Exparel or liposomal bupivacaine anything new? Well, the answer is no. Liposomes are actually the first nanodrug delivery systems. They have been around for a long time and that have been successfully translated into real-time clinical applications. And these phospholipid vessels have seen many technical advances in recent years, since their first development, actually in 1965. The liposomes alter the biodistribution profile of the drugs which are incorporated into them, which then enhances the therapeutic index of the various drugs. And there's a lot of research on nanodrug delivery systems, such as delivery of anti-cancer, antifungal, anti-inflammatory, and therapeutic genes, and so on. And yes, it's also being used in a Depo-Dur formulation or Exparel as well. So nothing really new that we should be suspicious about. The basic premise upon which liposomes would be beneficial in clinical practice and in pharmacology is as follows. If you take the drug with substantial toxicity or efficacy problems and you package them into liposomes, then basically you extend the efficacy and prolong the duration of the action of the drug as the free drug or active drug is being slowly released from the formulation of liposome. Exparel is basically the same liposomal formulation, just like any of these other drugs that we talked about, but with a proprietary depo-form delivery technology. It contains a number of discrete chambers within the lipid matrix, each one being filled with an active solution of the drug or active substance, which is bupivacaine. And this would be a possible mode of action of liposomal bupivacaine. As Exparel is injected into the tissue, you can see multitudes of liposomes that are present in the site of injection, whether that be local injection into the tissue or around peripheral nerves, it is very similar. In this animation, you can see the needle insertion inside the tissue and injection of the Exparel. And liposomal bupivacaine contains only 3% of the free active drug bupivacaine, which you can see here as the smoke. It is a very small amount that is available for the immediate action though, which is why mixing Exparel with free bupivacaine makes sense to get an immediate effect similar to that of bupivacaine hydrochloride. And the rest of the formulation is all liposomes that release bupivacaine over 72 plus hours, which is the major advantage of this liposomal formulation of bupivacaine in infiltration or in nerve blocks. Historically, Exparel or liposomal bupivacaine has been approved by the FDA in 2011 for injection into the surgical site. And since then, millions of patients were treated. And the fact that Exparel is still on the market and has never had a recall for safety despite a continuous safety surveillance means that the drug formulation is safe. In 2018, the agency also approved Exparel for use in interscalene brachial plexus block for postsurgical regional anesthesia. And this approval for this indication was based on a multi-institutional phase 3 double-blind placebo-controlled study that validated the efficacy, safety, and pharmacokinetics for use of the liposome bupivacaine in the brachial plexus block. This study was conducted at 16 sites across the United States and Europe, and the study found that Exparel, when injected into the interscalene brachial plexus block, substantially reduces the pain over placebo over 72 hours of application. So there's no question that Exparel is effective for nerve blocks that cover the surgical territory. Here's another representation of the liposomes, and these will be the phospholipid membranes. You can see them over here, and these membranes slowly degrade under the normal tissue metabolism when the drug then starts leaching or escaping into the neighboring tissue and therefore provides bupivacaine for nerve blocks or local infiltration for the nerve endings. And that would look something like this. And this is how that really looks like in animation. That's the best way that I know how to illustrate how Exparel actually works. But why was Exparel approved for interscalene brachial plexus blocks but not for any other peripheral nerve block? If the drug was approved in 2011 for local infiltration that affects the small nerves and nerve endings, and now for major nerve blocks for interscalene brachial plexus block, it should be similarly effective and safe for all other block injection models from the small nerves to the other plexuses. And that is the question that I do not have the answer to. It is like approving ibuprofen for the pain in the right hand, but not for the pain in the left hand, or approving ibuprofen for pain in the shoulder, but not for the pain in the foot. And this is really a valid question because the nerves across the entire nervous system are very similar. So if the concerns of toxicity are an issue, then the interscalene brachial plexus block is the one block where we are most concerned about toxicity because of the abundance of the vasculature and proximity to the great vessels. And yet, in this application, Exparel was deemed to be safe in interscalene brachial plexus block and therefore approved, but not for any other more distal, much safer and more simpler nerve blocks. So really, why not approve it for other nerve blocks? And again, this question is a really good one because in 2016, the pharma submitted the data to the FDA, which was based on a multi-institutional study designed to meet the FDA standards for approval of new pharmacological agents in femoral nerve block for post-surgical anesthesia after total knee arthroplasty. And in this study, Exparel or liposomal bupivacaine was also found to be better than placebo and without side effects. And the study actually concluded that Exparel resulted in a moderate decrease in pain scores compared to placebo. And again, this is what the agencies look for approval. They look for efficacy against placebo and they look for safety or the absence of side effects. So it's really puzzling now we have a drug approved for interscalene brachial plexus block, but not for any other indications. And even more confusing is the fact that the European medicines agencies actually approved Exparel for femoral nerve block also and interscalene brachial plexus block based on the very same data that were presented to the FDA that I just presented. So the question is, are European nerves different than American nerves? After all, most Americans are of European origin. In summary, this first video on Exparel discussed the importance of our specialty leaders to refocus attention from the race of inventing new blocks and injection methods, me too, needle here versus needle there, to how to make the best out of the novel pharmacology that may actually increase the value of these analgesic techniques, may increase the duration of analgesia and the benefits of these blocks. We also briefly discussed the literature that documented the analgesic efficacy of liposomal bupivacaine in interscalene brachial plexus block, but in the next video, we'll talk about the best way to use Exparel for success in approved indications, and we will start dissecting some literature that does require critical review. And make sure you subscribe to NYSORA YouTube channel and don't miss out on our new videos. Until next time.